In today's video, I am going to explain anatomical relationship of psoas. I will explain the relationship of muscle in first part, then in second part, I'm gonna explain relationship with internal organ. First thing first, this is psoas. It is on deep part of abdomen and it goes to hip joint. I'm not going to talk about its function. Important thing is it is on deep part of abdomen. The most famous relationship is with iliacus. Iliacus. Then psoas and iliacus together, it is called iliopsoas. Iliopsoas, right? You have heard that. Then psoas is sometimes called psoas major. Psoas major, that means big psoas, correct? If there is major, there should be minor. There should be psoas minor. Where is that? It's a little bit hard to see in this picture. That's it. This is it. This is psoas minor. This muscle is not present for everybody. About 60% of population has this muscle. It's about 60%. By the way, it goes to pelvis. Psoas major attaches to femur. Psoas minor attaches to pelvis. Okay, this is the relationship with other muscle. Iliacus and psoas minor, and there are few more important connections. Next one is this muscle. This is quadratus lumborum. Quadratus lumborum. This muscle attaches to pelvis, 12th rib, and lumbar spines. This muscle is freaking important for low back pain and stiff low back. Then, quadratus lumborum and psoas are kind of facing each other. They are next to next. You know what I'm talking about? So when psoas doesn't work, maybe your quadratus lumborum doesn't work, then what's gonna happen? Maybe you have stiff low back. Maybe you have low back pain. Again, quadratus lumborum is freaking important for low back pain. I will show you the relationship of these two muscles for later on. I just want you to remember quadratus lumborum and psoas are very close each other. Let me explain one more connection with muscle. Again, this is psoas major. This is psoas. The last relationship is this guy. This is, of course, diaphragm. This is proximal part of psoas. Okay, this is proximal part of psoas. Look at that. This part of diaphragm is close to psoas. Then what is this part? This is crura. Crura of diaphragm. Crura means leg. It looks like leg of diaphragm. Psoas and diaphragm. If your psoas doesn't work, maybe your diaphragm gets tension. What's gonna happen? Maybe your breathing is not functioning as properly, right? Then if you're not breathing properly, maybe that affects psoas. This deep connection is important for core stability, thorax stability, breathing, so many things. I explained relationship with muscle so far. Psoas minor, iliacus, quadratus lumborum, and diaphragm. Let me explain relationship with skeletal system, just little quick. Let me talk about origin of psoas. Origin of psoas is lumbar spines and T12, thoracic spine and lumbar spines. Plus, psoas attaches to intervertebral disc. Oh, that sounds so interesting. What is function of intervertebral disc? This is shock absorber of spines. That said, if psoas gets tight, maybe this tension put a lot of tension for discs. That's gonna be a problem. Again, function of discs is shock absorbing, right? Then that tension of psoas may aggravate this shock absorbing system. Thus, adequate tension of psoas is important for hip, lumbar spines, breathing, and even for thorax. Now let me talk about relationship with internal organs. Most famous organ with psoas is this guy. This is kidney. Because psoas is very deep muscle, this muscle has relationship with deep organs, particularly retroperitoneal organ. You don't have to memorize what retroperitoneal organ is. They are deep organ. It's simple, right? Retroperitoneal organs are deep organ, such as kidney. Because kidney is deep, it is close to psoas. It's simple. When kidney got dysfunction, maybe that affects psoas. Why? Because they are so close. This is very common that when I do visceral manipulation for kidney, tendency is tension of psoas decreases. Oftentimes, not always, but this is high tendency. You know, visceral manipulation may affect tension of muscular system. This is important to know, right? Again, kidney and psoas, because they are very close each other. Now let me explain a few more organs that have relationship with psoas. This is profile view. This part is psoas. Then kidney is here. See, they are so close. By the way, this is quadratus lumborum. Quadratus lumborum and psoas are also very close each other. See how close kidney and psoas and quadratus lumborum are? This area, so important for stiff low back and low back pain. Two more organs. One thing is this one. This is large intestine. Large intestine. And this is duodenum. Duodenum. Large intestine, particularly on the lateral part, and duodenum are also retroperitoneal organs. What is it? That's deep organ, right? Part of large intestine and duodenum are also deep organ. That means they have relationship with psoas. Oh my gosh, this is so important thing. Again, when I do visceral manipulation for large intestine, duodenum and kidney, tendency is the tension of psoas oftentimes decrease. See, psoas has so many relationship with muscular system and internal organs. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.